Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie. I'm the editor-in-chief at theserverside.com, and you can follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ. And I want to talk to you about UiPath programming and specifically how the If Then Else facility works. So I did a tutorial earlier on the number guesser. Take a look at that. I did that purely with a do while loop. In this example, I'm going to achieve the same ends, but I'm going to do it with an if then else statement, nesting some of those if conditions inside of each other. So if you want to learn the basics of conditional programming in UiPath, you've come to the right place. Now I'm going to implement the number guesser with an if-then, nested if-then statement. So I'm going to create a new project called the if-then nest number guesser. I think that's a long enough name. I'll allow the workspace to come up, and as soon as it does open up, I'll open up the main workflow window. And I'm going to start off by adding in a do while loop. So that means going down into workflow, opening up the control element, and adding a do while loop here. Now, I actually want an infinite loop, and that sounds a little strange. But what I want to do is I want to keep asking the user, hey, what's your pick? What number did you pick? What number did you pick? I just want that to keep going on and on and on until they pick the right number. And when they pick the right number, I'm going to break out of the loop. And so this actually creates an infinite loop, which is kind of interesting. And inside of this loop, I want to ask the user for some input. So that means going into system, dialog, input dialog, and dragging input dialog onto the body here. And I'm going to have a title. This will be in the title bar of the dialog box, and we'll say pick. Pick a number between 1 and 10, and we'll say in the dialog box, what is your number? Now remember, this has to all go within double quotes. If you don't have double quotes here, you're going to have a problem. So just make sure that's in double quotes. Only variables go without the quotes. Speaking of variables, when somebody types in a number, we actually want to store that as a variable. So that means I got to come down to this variables element here. I want to store what the user's guess is, and it should be a number. So I'm going to make it int32, and I'm going to give scope for the entire sequence. If you don't give scope for this entire sequence, that variable can only be used inside of the section in which it's declared. If you give it scope for the sequence, it can be used anywhere inside of the big sequence block. Now I've got that variable guess declared. When somebody types something into the input box, I want that value, that number, to be assigned to guess. So I put that over here under output. What happens when somebody type something into that field, well, that gets pushed out here into that variable. So now when somebody types in a number, that guess field is going to be initialized. So what do we want to do after that? Well, after that, I want to check to see if the number that they typed in was too low. And so I drag an if block over. I'm not going to bring it from recent there. I'll let you see where you can find it. It goes under, I always forget where it goes here. It goes under system, activities, statements, and then there's that if statement there. And when I drag it on, you'll notice that it's actually an if then. And so I'll say, if, what's the condition? The guess is less than 5, then what do we want to do? In that case, we'll send them a message box that says guess higher. And then what do we do if it's not less than 5? That means it's greater than 5. Then I guess we should say guess lower. The only problem is the possibility exists that they actually picked 5, which is the correct number. So we've actually got to nest our if then else statements. And that means throwing an if statement over here to the right. And then in this if statement, we'll say if the guess is greater than 5, then we'll tell them to guess lower. And then what happens if their number is not less than 5, not greater than 5, if it actually is 5? Well, we can now put that into this else block here. And that would be a message box saying, you guessed it, it was, and then what the guess was. Because the guess is right, if we actually get to this point, that means they've guessed 5. Guess is holding the value 5, so this should print up, you guessed it, it was 5. Now we do have this issue about the infinite loop here, and unfortunately we don't have infinite resources. So when somebody guess is the right answer, we actually want to break out of the loop. And so how do you do that? All I have to do is go down to workflow control and you'll find this break. And if you drag the break over here, you notice it now says, okay, when somebody guesses it right, we'll say, hey, you guessed it right. The number was what the guess was, and then the break. And that break forces you to break out of the current loop that you're inside of. So that will kind of override this true, because this condition won't ever get executed. Once that break happens, we break out of the loop, and then execution actually would follow along if there was anything below after the loop. And actually, I could even prove that out by just putting a message box here after the condition and saying, and so now the message box says, thanks for playing. So that'll show you that we break out of the loop, but it's not a way of terminating the application. It's not like an exception was thrown or something like that. Now, what did I do wrong? Now on that guess, I gotta say guess.toString. I always forget to do that. That's an int, and they don't like connecting ints and strings if you're doing strong typing. So that was one little thing that I forget there. But otherwise, I think this all looks really handsome. Yeah, I don't know if that makes things any better or any worse, but that's what it looks like all put together. And let's give this a run. So I'll run the application. What's your number? Type in 2. Guess higher. What's your number? 7. Guess lower. What's your number? I'll type in 5. You guessed it. It was 5. That should trigger the break. And then after the break, after the loop, it says, thanks for playing. And there you go. That's how you can do some interesting flow control with nested loops. So there you go. Those are the ins and outs of nested if-then-else statements. If you enjoyed this tutorial, head over to theserverside.com, where I'm the editor-in-chief. You can find lots of great articles and tutorials about enterprise software development over there. If you want to learn more about me, you can follow my antics on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.